I met Haley when I was on break for school. I was in California and I came back and we were at this place. They were up at the church, a place called Anka or something, some game that Weber State plays. And they were all playing the game and I saw some girl with some short black shorts and some little shirt on. And I just thought that she was smoldering hot and I just told my friends that I was going to date that girl and that she was going to be mine. And then she was friends with one of my friends, and so a year later, I'd planned on moving back, and Ethan was the friend that I was telling him about, and she had told him about me. My friend's coming from California, he's moving back, blah, blah, blah. Long story short, and then when I first got back, the 2 days that I moved back home, she was at Lake Powell, and then that's where we met, and then after Lake Powell, it was just every day after that. But the cool thing was about the story is that she started liking me first. Like, she asked me to come watch a movie. She, like, when I text her, she'd said, "It's about time you text me." So that was kind of cool that she had courted me and I didn't really have to do any work, which was awesome. So
hear that, everybody? Haley made the first move.
That's right. Our first date, our first 2 weeks, we just hung out and made out the whole time. That was kind of our first date. But we went to dinner after a week or two of hanging out, we went to Corbin's for dinner. But I never really wanted to be like that with Haley. I wanted to get to know her first. I didn't like typical dates. That's not my style. So I never liked to just, let's go to dinner and a movie. I wanted to hang out with her a little bit.
Yeah.
Which is exactly what we're not supposed to do, is hang out. It's the date. But Corbin's is where we went for dinner. Preston and JC's Love Sack. Downstairs in their family room, and it was fantastic. We told each other we loved each other in my bedroom. I was a nervous pile of crap the entire time. I was shaking and I couldn't breathe. It took me like 5 minutes to tell her, and then she told me, but it was good.
So you told her first?
Yeah, I told her first. She was sitting there, and I told her I had to tell her something, and we just sat there, and I was like, couldn't breathe. I was like panting, because I'd never really like loved someone like that, so it was weird for me, because I just never was like that before until Haley. So if it's something that you want. My favorite characteristic about Haley is she's extremely smart, and she exudes love. Everybody loves her so much. And I just think that when you have someone that people like come to, or they just want to be around that person, I think that's a very powerful thing. And I love that about her, that she can make anybody feel special and feel good just by talking to her. It doesn't matter who you are. And I just think that's a brilliant thing to have about her. So I love that about her. Just kiss me slowly. Physical feature is her entire body. And she's going to know this answer. She knows I love her small frame. That was why I was very first attracted to her. I've always liked short girls. So literally her entire body is what I love about her.
Okay.
Nordstrom and Express is Haley's favorite. And she'd like some G-Star jeans as well. Shoe size is 6. It's always been about Haley wants 3 or 4 kids.
Okay, how many kids does Colin want?
3 or 4. We share the same, which is brilliant.
Awesome. Did you have to negotiate at all?
No, that's what I've always wanted, and she wanted it, and it just worked out.
Perfect.
Yeah. I like Haley's long hair. I just want it so long. She knows that. I like it curly when it's all nice and done, and then also to the side when she just has her face open and one to the side.
I love it.
One word for Haley would be beautiful. I would say her phone. That's really, she has tons of other stuff, but her phone for sure. Haley, this is an exciting time for us. We've been counting down the days on your phone, and it's just coming down to it, and I just super stoked to marry you. Never thought I'd meet you. Never. I'd always complain to my mom and my dad when I was like, just call them and be like, I don't think I'm ever gonna find my wife. And I remember when I was in Newport Beach at a ward, and the state president said to me that you need to live worthy of your wife. And I thought that was really cool. It kind of touched home to me. And then that's kind of when I started inspired that I needed to come home. It was kind of started my like urge to get home. And I was just, I would worry sick about it. And I knew when I saw you that I had to have you and I wanted you. And I just think that's really cool. And I think that both of us have felt the spirit that this is right. And I think that's just a beautiful, cool thing when two people can connect like that together. And I can't wait to marry you. I love you so much. It's crazy how much I love you. You're the most important person to me in the entire world. And we're going to be together forever and the eternities, and our kids and grandkids. It's going to be a fantastic time. I love you, baby. I do.